about Wiscan, about some of his museums built in the US. And this is, in this way, the occasion to talk about truth in architecture. Pavel Florensky, during a lesson for his students at Vucemas in Moscow, said, "We must start from the very concept of the work of art. The work in itself is a reality that overcomes itself. It allows and gives us more than what it is directly through the perception of the senses. On one end, the work is subject to given laws that regulate what is represented, but on the other hand, it depends on other laws based on the fact that it represents something. In other words, general relationship, general schemes, general laws of organization of the work of art in itself exist, but at the same time, it is not extraneous also to other relationships, to schemes and laws that concern not the work, but what is represented in it. Consequently, it is twice a unit, the work. This duality, if expressed in a common language, represent the two moments of composition and construction." And what it is really interesting is that Pavel Florensky, even if he's talking about art in general, used two words very important for architecture: composition and construction. Again, Florensky, "Composition is the unit that is deposited by the artist in the work when he chooses a given space. In other words, we can say that, in a certain sense, composition is the function of the artist who creates the work. Construction is the unit of things represented in that work. It is also a function, but not only of the artist, but of that reality towards which the work is addressed. Composition is what the artist brings in the work. Construction is what to contend with. Construction is what the world forces to recognize of the world itself." In the lesson by Florensky, it is clear that composition and construction have to be a unit. This is really true in architecture. This means that form and space are in a strict relationship in architecture. The first cannot exist without the second, and the second cannot exist without the first. This is a possible definition of what is the truth in architecture: unity of composition and construction, of form and space, in order to build places for the human inhabitants. Moreover, this is the lesson that the main part of the contemporary architecture seems to have lost: taking care of building, not spaces for inhabiting, but images to be sold as a product of a global market. On the contrary, it is a lesson that we can still recognize in the work of the great master of architecture, and among them, Louis Kahn, that define architecture in this way: architecture is the thoughtful making of spaces. It is the creating of spaces that evoke a feeling of appropriate use. And it's quite interesting that a philosopher, Georgi Lukács, defined architecture in a very similar way. Architecture, for Lukács, is a construction of a real and adequate space that visually evokes adequacy. So the museum by Louis Kahn will be the occasion to oppose some lies about Louis Kahn. The first one is that Kahn was not interested in the relationship between expressive form of architecture and form of construction. And the second lie is that Kahn is a functionalist. Regarding the idea of museum as a path during the 20th century, two big masters introduced significant innovation of sense. The first is obviously Miss van der Rohe with the Museum Temple in Berlin. In this collage, you can see that Francesco Venezia, an Italian architect, moved the Neue Nationalgalerie of Berlin in the Temple's Ballet in Pestum. And the second architect that innovated the sense of the museum was exactly Louis Kahn, that for the Manil Museum, talk about museum as a storage, a space where the materials were not chronologically ordered, but saved, and the space was able to host any kind of exhibition. The first museum I want to show is the Yale University Art Gallery that Kahn designed in 1951 when he came back from a very important trip in Italy, Greece, Egypt, that really influenced his way of make architecture. It is a difficult project because it was the enlargement of an existing building, but I wrote somewhere that Kahn solved all the project with two moves. The first move concerned the exterior of the building. On the right, you can see the facade along Chapel Street that is blind, completely blind, in brick, only with the volume postponed in order to solve the problem of the connection with the existing building, but not only for this reason. And on the left, you can see the facade, the opposite facade on York Street, completely in glass, in order where the space is more private, more domestic, to show the interiority of the museum. This is the point of the connection between the ancient building on the right and the new building. And it's clear that this is a very good solution in order to preserve, but to reveal at the same time the entrance of the museum if you are walking along the street. And this is the different character of the building, also in the facade towards the garden and towards the buildings of the campus, completely transparent. And this image, I think, it's really clear to explain how beautiful is this project if related to the problem of the relationship in architecture between the ancient and the new. As I said, the second move for Kahn is about the definition of the interior space. Here you can see clearly the idea of Kahn of design plans of the building with a clear difference between servant and served spaces. Here we have in the middle, the core of the building, all the servant spaces, vertical connection, services, and so on. And then with the interesting structural solution, the possibility to have two undivided spaces of about 15 by 25 meters, cleaned thanks to the structural function solution, and able to host any kind of exhibition. This is an important drawing for me, a kind of axonometrical view from Bloch. We are going to talk about this way of represent buildings. And here the structural solution, this roof that the engineer that worked in strict cooperation with Kahn described as a multiplanar truss system, a space frame of equilateral triangles with the entire top surface filled in to provide the floor, and with alternate inclined triangles in each of the three dimensions also made solid. This is the solution that evoke a beautiful drawing that Kahn made during his trip in Egypt of pyramids. And I think these images are able to demonstrate that Kahn is not interested in the functional problem, not in the exhibition problem, in the exhibition program, but only interested in built beautiful spaces able to host the works of art. More or less 10 years after, Kahn worked on the Kimball Art Museum in Texas in a very different context, less urban, a kind of widespread context. And so he interpreted differently the theme of the museum, building a villa into a garden. And this is the reason why I don't like very much the position of the enlargement of the museum by Renzo Piano, because it occupies the garden and central axis of the composition. Well, if I said two moves in the Yale Art Gallery, in Kimball, I think there is only one move, the span of 32 by 7 meters, with the long side in the north-south direction, covered with the famous cycloid walls, repeated 6 times in the 2 lateral blocks and 4 in the central. The idea of the villa surroundings by a garden is confirmed by the final span that are porticos, and by the presence of the patios inside the building. The underground level allow to host all the services, all the technical services, having in the ground floor, also in this case, two large, huge, undivided spaces for exhibition. Again, an axonometrical view from below. And here the structural solution developed with engineer commandant is the cycloid vault, able to bring the light, the natural light inside the building, but not directly on the works of art, but reflected in a kind of silver light that is what characterizes this extraordinary interior space of the Kimball museum. Also in this case, I think Kahn is really interested in problem of construction and really not interested in functional problem. Many scholars wrote that probably Kahn is thinking about the Louvre Gallery designed by Hubert Robert, but I think that probably Kahn decided to realize the dream by Etienne Louis Boulet and this library of France. Interesting essay of the historian Jacques Blair has tried to demonstrate that the rational discipline is in the architecture of Kahn before the compositional play. And this discipline is related to what Gubler defined as Gothicism in the architecture of Kahn, which is in the figurative, said Gubler, concomitants of plan and constructive system. This is the reason why I showed the axonometrical view from below, a way of representation that Auguste Choisy invented for his Histoire de l'architecture. The building under investigation were represented by Choisy with this axonometric view from below, able to represent in the same time a plan and a section, typology and space. Moreover, I think all the museum by Kahn demonstrated that for him function is not the crucial point of architecture. Central point in Kahn project has been the idea of space, well organized through typology. It is well known that Kahn has been reflecting deeply on human institutions and their sense more than on their functional organization. Kahn said, as a professional, you are obliged to translate the program of a client into that of the space the institution this building is to serve. You might say it is a space order or a space realm of this activity of man. And finally, Kahn to his students, in order to explain how not important is function in architecture, said that I never read the program literally. It is like writing to Picasso and saying, I want my portrait painted. I want two eyes in it and one nose and only one mouth, please. And this is my last image and my last sentence. Thank you. Hoping to see you soon in Krakow.